How old were you when you were adopted?
I was about 3.5 years old.
And what made you start questioning things?
Honestly, nothing really made me start questioning things until I was probably older. My birth certificate says I'm a native Hawaiian. As you can see, I have very few Hawaiian features. It might have been when I had skin cancer for the fifth time that I was kind of starting to line everything up. It didn't really fall into place until probably in my early 30s, I started to think about having children, wanting to find out my health history and finding out about that day, those whole issues. But besides that, no, I never really questioned, my whole birth thing.
So tell us why you decided to check the National Centre for Missing and Exploited Children's website and how you, I guess, discovered this photo of yourself as a child.
Yeah, it was the day Carlina White had found herself online. She was an 18-year-old woman out of New York who was abducted, at a very young age. And it popped up 4 or 5 times in the morning and then again while I was at work. And I had, a half hour at lunch. So I closed my office door and went on to missingkids.org. And, it was easy enough. I was born in Hawaii. I put in Hawaii male. And I had just turned 33 that year. So I put in, I had been missing for 32 years. And, nothing came up. People came up, but it wasn't anything that looked like me. And I was like, I just turned 33. I might want to check it again. And I put in the extra year, and then all of a sudden, the first image that came up was that age progression photo of a missing child who went missing the same time I did. Had a birthday a day after my birthday, and looked very similar to how I look.
What was going through your mind at that stage? Could you believe this?
it was. It was a very interesting day. This was back when everybody was on chat, so I immediately sent it out to a number of different friends asking, oh my God, this is me. I think this missing child is me. And I'd say, who does this look like? And I got all sorts of horrible responses, but everybody basically came back to the fact that, wow, that picture looks exactly like you. That is you. And then from there it went to me calling my parents and kind of walking my parents through the whole thing and trying to talk them off the ledge that, we adopted you, everything was legal. And I was like, I'm not trying to say that. I'm just saying, hey, listen, this is what I just found.
So what was your next step? I'm guessing a DNA test or something like that?
No, so it was very interesting. I found the picture, I sent it to my parents via email, and then again, I had to walk my parents into how to open email. So when they opened it, they saw the picture, and then realized that it looked like me, and then asked me to, really think about what I wanted to do here, that was my decision on how to move forward, to talk to my soon-to-be wife then, and figure out a plan. And, at the time, I didn't really have children, and it was funny, everybody I talked to had totally different separate views. People with children were immediately telling me to call the police. You've been missing. I don't care how long it's been. You have to let them know you've been found. And then people who didn't have kids were like, wow, that's a crazy story. So, my mom said, just keep it quiet, think about what you want to do, and then follow through. And then later that night, I talked to my wife, and we figured out it would probably be a good idea to call the police. So called the Honolulu Police Department, and then I called my parents to let them know that, I'd called the police department, at which point they told me that they had already called the police department for me and sent over all my paperwork. So, kind of beat me to the punch.
Did you manage to track down your biological parents or any other blood relatives and get any answers to what happened to you as a child?
Yeah, actually, my half-sister, Jennifer, had continued to search for me since I went missing with my mother all that time ago. And the whole reason that this was kind of made forefront was there was a push in, 2005 by President Bush to find missing children, and mine was one of the top cases. So they had made a big push to find me, and as soon as I had located myself and went through the DNA testing, they put me in contact not only with my half-sister, but also with my biological father.
So what had actually happened to you? Why were you a missing person?
Well, that's the crazy thing. Nobody really knows. There are a couple of different theories, and I think there'll always be theories until we find out. But I went for a walk with my mother when I was 6 months old. My stroller was found at the bus stop at the end of our street. And then from there, I ended up in Child Protective Services under a different name. My name was Tenzin Amai. My ethnicity was changed to Native Hawaiian, and my birthday was changed to a day back. So I got a brand new birth certificate, and then was put into an orphanage and lived in an orphanage until I was adopted until 3 and a half. So while, speculation probably has my mother taking me out of the family home in Haula and transporting me down to Honolulu, I ended up in an orphanage in Waipahu and was adopted by a family on Schofield Barracks.
So, Steve, knowing what you've gone through so far, for often people who are adopted say they feel like there's a part of them missing and they need to kind of have those answers. Do you have any regrets or are you glad what you did?
Interesting question. I think definitely I'm glad, because for my biological family, the story is completed. Mm-hmm. They know that I'm safe. Now, meanwhile, my mom, Charlotte Moriarty, is still missing, and, God rest her soul, we'll find her someday. But, I was raised in an amazing home, amazing family, grew up with amazing friends, and now have been able to reconnect with my biological family. And more than that, in the United States, we have the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children, and they're the ones who actually produced that age progression photo. And it's only because of that that I was actually able to connect the dots. And without their work and their help, none of this would have been possible. So my half-sister, my father, my other relatives would still be searching without answers. And I think the big thing is, a lot of people don't believe in those age progression photos, but as you can see, they built that progression photo off of a picture of myself at 3 months old and my mom at 27 and my dad at 26.
It's incredible technology and an extraordinary story. Steve, thank you so much for joining us on Studio 10 and sharing with the story with us this morning. It is much appreciated.
My pleasure. Thank you very much.